A decorated US Navy SEAL team leader has been found not guilty of premeditated murder in the death of an Islamic State prisoner in Iraq. The trial, which set platoon leader Edward Gallagher against his own subordinates, became a conservative cause célèbre.
In the San Diego sunshine, celebrating a stunning end to a sensational war crimes trial.
Huge victory, huge weight off the Gallaghers. Huge victory for justice.
40-year-old Special Operations Chief Edward Gallagher was accused of committing seven crimes during a 2017 tour of Iraq, including murdering this teenage IS prisoner, seen wounded in this Iraqi TV video. During the legal process, President Trump's preferred TV network, Fox News, weighed in.
The murder of an ISIS dirtbag.
And President Trump hinted at a pardon.
It's a little bit controversial. It's very possible that I'll let the trials go on and I'll make my decision after the trial.
But that was far from the only unusual aspect of the case. Fellow SEAL Corey Scott, who was granted immunity, testified that he saw his boss Gallagher stab the teenager in the neck. But then Scott testified that he, not Gallagher, killed the teen to prevent him from being tortured by Iraqi forces, saying, "I knew he was going to die anyway." Edward Gallagher's defence team had this argument against those platoon members who'd turned him in.
This is not a murder. This is a mutiny. This is a group of young, disgruntled sailors that didn't like being told that they were cowards. And so they decided to conspire to take down the chief.
The SEAL, convicted of a single crime, taking a photo with the body of a dead captive, was limited in his post-trial remarks.
Yeah, I'm happy and I'm thankful. And thank God.
But his wife, who long campaigned for her husband, not holding back.
This vindication, I hope, will be a lesson learned to everybody that we need to uphold innocent until proven guilty, due process, and we need to afford the benefit of the doubt to our war heroes who we send over there to fight these evils.
The trial concluding as President Trump again tweeted his praise of the US military, and 48 hours before Independence Day celebrations, which this year will include tanks on the streets of the nation's capital, an historic departure. Prulawan SBS World News.